Each spring, New Englanders have the opportunity to view an incredible natural phenomenon. The American shad and other anadromous fish make their way up the Connecticut River to begin their annual natural migration. In tonight's edition of Life with Monte, WRSI Radio's Monte Belmonte heads to the Barrett Fishway at the Holyoke Dam to see how these fish get a helping hand, or more accurately, a helpful elevator ride over the dam before continuing on their journey upstream.
There's an old saying that says, a woman needs a man like a fish needs a bicycle, which may or may not be true, but sometimes what a fish does need is an elevator. And we are at the Robert Barrett Fishway, part of Holyoke Gas and Electric in Holyoke, tapping the awesome power of the Connecticut River. I'm here with the chief steward of the Connecticut River, the head of the Connecticut River Watershed Council, who keeps an eye on the span of the Connecticut River from top to bottom.
We give it our best shot.
Andy Fisk. Andy, we've heard about the fish elevator if we lived in this area, the fish lift.
Yep.
What is this place and what does it do for the fish and the river ultimately?
That's right. So this time of year, the fish that are living in the ocean, something happened and said, time to head up the river. So right now we have shad, lamprey, sturgeon that are coming up the river and they're trying to find a place to raise their family. So when the river gets warm and there's enough water, they start heading up. But you know what happens when a fish swims into a wall, right? What does it say?
Turn around, man.
That's it. So, since the 1950s, Holyoke Gas and Electric has done a really terrific job getting the fish over the dam, and they have an elevator to now help those fish do that.
So, as you can probably hear at the top of this fish lift, it's really loud and powerful. But, Andy, explain a little bit how the elevator works, and then this new innovation, this water slide behind us.
That's right. So, it's fish passage is about the fish getting up the river and then down. So over here, you have the river coming. The fish are going to be swimming up the river, and the elevator entrances are right here. And when the elevator gets enough fish in it, they push the button, ding, and the elevator goes up. So that's getting them up. If you're a fish and you want to come down river, they build a water slide. And
that's
this big flume of water here. You could try it.
I'd love to.
Right?
I don't know if I'd make it.
Monty's slip and slide. So the fish are going to come through, and they're basically going to ride a flume inside this dam. And this is a major reconstruction on the dam, so that if you're a fish that likes swimming down low, you got to root into the slide. If you like swimming up hop, you got to root down the slide. And they come down here. When you see turbulence, there's a lot of air in the water, so it's a safe cushion. Because you could imagine if you went sliding over the dam and you hit the rocks, splat.
Doesn't make for a good fish.
It does not. And so the slide is doing a bunch of work for fish coming up and for fish going down.
And this is a pretty recent innovation, kind of thanks to the research of the Connecticut River Watershed Council, right?
Just opened this year, not our research, but we've been talking with the dam owners for about 12 years. What's the best way to make fish passage better? That's part of what we do.
And it seems to be working so far so good.
So far so good.
So the dam is so loud and so powerful, we're having to do the interview here at the foot of the dam, essentially. But are they using this to generate power too? I mean, so many people want to get us off fossil fuel, but there's a blessing and a curse with using hydro, and especially when you dam a river, both here and in Turner's Falls.
Exactly. So it's Holyoke Gas and Electric. It's a municipal utility, and yes, they're generating electricity. Holyoke's really proud of the amount of energy they generate from renewable sources, but it's a trade-off.
Right.
So that's what we have to figure out. You got to put a lot of money into fish passage so that we can restore all these fish, but also generate electricity in a way that really is renewable. And so they're doing a better balance here.
So here we are in the viewing area. The fish have been elevated, the alarm went off, and these shad mostly are waiting to go up over the dam, right, Andy?
That's it, heading to Turner's Falls and up to Vernon and even beyond Vernon.
And our fingers are crossed that these make it the whole way. You can come here to Holyoke to the fish lift Wednesdays through Sundays through June 12th for a tour and see these fish for yourself. Well, not these fish, they'll be long gone.